Radiant team ban. Dire team ban. Remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve. Radiant team pick.
Vengeful spirit.
Dire team pick.
It is I, Mott, joining you today after 36 hours of no sleep. I got like 9 good hours of sleep last night, and I felt so good.
Feels good, man.
And not only that, but we played some seriously good pubs beforehand. It was like me, Blake, Sevi played one with us. We had Brax, Shane, and we dominated. Like, we absolutely wrecked. Yeah. It was fantastic.
Actually, both games were comebacks. Yeah, right? Like both games looked grim at some point.
Oh, but yeah. There, we had a 40k net worth comeback in one game, yeah. Actually.
Brax, which, Tinker.
Yeah, he played Tinker. He actually... He played Tinker, and he's like, guys, we can win this. And he was half joking at the time. And then they just started throwing, and it was great. It was fucking fantastic. Anyways, enough about that. There's a draft happening. This is a good hero. I realized this last night that this is a very good hero.
Dazzle is definitely high on the radar right now for SG. Minus armor strats seem to be very kind of popular in this region, but they'll go for the Rubick. So yeah, the supports that are big in this region, Caudle, Venge, Dazzle, Rubick, Warlock. I'm surprised to see the Earth Spirit ban, but...
Dang. They just threw an apple across stream. Excellent.
Hey, guys.
I suppose it's targeted. Hey, Annie.
What's
Hello.
Up?
Good morning.
I thought we had another hour.
You smell like
yeah,
shampoo.
They moved it up.
Yeah, so I was definitely in the shower when I got the 3-minute warning on the cast.
No bears were present. Too.
Reserve time.
That's a problem. And then they put you on for this too.
Oh yeah, I'm so excited.
You're gonna be good. We are into the draft though. It is Rubick that is picked up for SG, and then a couple more bans coming out here. So we were talking about this earlier. The biggest thing obviously was that Infamous is now out, which to me is shocking because I thought
snap.
That was a pretty good team.
10 seconds remaining. Radiant team back. Dire team pick.
Did you see the Not Today game yesterday with them and SG? They looked... They had some mistakes in the second game, but in the first game, they were perfect. I think they look like that next step up in terms of team caliber. Even SG Esports, which is a great team, I think, they were having some serious trouble.
Yeah.
I think there's a chance SG could beat Not Today, but I haven't seen Midas Club Elite play that much, so I have to figure out, okay, well, how good are these guys? How good are they going to do?
I think the Bardo, who's their four... sometimes three, depending on the hero, has been playing out of his mind, especially on his Nyx Assassin.
Right.
But they get the Centaur here. But yeah, he's been... this is very interesting. So SG Esports, I think what's been happening with them is they look very dominant in the group stage. They were running these kind of unorthodox four positions, Clockwork and Slardar for King RD, and they would roam him with a Wisp for Cat. So I think teams have started to kind of... get notice of that, and now they're stealing the Clockwork way despite having a Centaur Warrunner. So just taking SG out of their comfort zone, yeah. And SG's looked a lot more shaky with those heroes out of their hands than they have with them in. So comfort picks are stolen, basically.
So how does Midas Club lane this now with a Clockwork and a Centaur? Did they just put the Centaur on the floor?
Roaming Clockwork support.
Yeah, they'll roam the clock and SA. That's what's most popular. Yeah. I mean, there's a possibility for the Centaur to go jungle for sure. He's definitely the more jungle ready hero.
I think, and they get this is why I like the Clockwork third pick too, because you don't have that ban unless you want to take Shadow Fiend. If you're SG Esports, you're gonna have to let Midas Club League get that. So in essence, they're gonna have 20 extra bonus damage for the Shadow Fiend in the early game, which is just, it's a nice little combination. You don't necessarily need the Shadow Fiend or the Clockwork, or you could use either of them to their own, you know, advantages, but. I think you can have the Clockwork sit mid for a couple minutes as well to help out the Shadow Fiend last hit if he needs it, or he can just roam elsewhere.
And there's more synergy than just that. I mean, double raise is guaranteed if you hook and cogs an enemy target. So Shadow Fiend always benefits from having frontline, benefits from having the extra move speed from the Stampede. So Centaur Clockwork in front of SF definitely bodes well. The other thing that makes this SF pick not really perilous at all is the fact that Venge Rubick are kind of a crappy ganking duo in the early game. They both have very low cast range. Like, the highest cast range of their two disables is 550 on telekinesis, so it's very difficult to gank the SF out of mid lane. So I think Midas Club see the opening there, and I think it's a good pick too. SG do go for the SF for ADR once in a while, but I think honestly ADR, it's one of his kind of weaker heroes. I think his Invoker and his Ember Spirit are much stronger than his SF. So
he had an Invoker game yesterday where he crushed it.
Is this for sure a support Venge though?
It could be core. It's a good point.
Seen a lot of core Venge now.
Yeah, it's a very good point.
I'm also wondering where the Sand King is going to be. I think it's more than likely an offlane Sand King, but there's just, I saw yesterday Sand King just in the jungle. It was kind of like it was the Clockwork and the Sand King together, and they played it sort of like a combined 3-4 position.
Yeah.
Oh. Do you guys believe me if I was going to say this is like a really good TA game for SG?
I would.
I'll believe you. Yeah. Absolutely. And it's this region. I mean, she's been banned a lot, but this region is really heavily kind of aware of the minus armor strats. SG have opened with Slardar Dazzle a lot. Venge is a little less common for them, but this is something that they definitely always have on their radar, and that hasn't been able to slip through for them. But it is a shift in gears for them. Like I said, teams are kind of just getting aware of their picks, so it remains to be seen, you know, how they do with a good lineup, but a lineup that's not necessarily comfort zone for them. I mean, TA has a great matchup for SF mid, so.
But again, there is going to be the extra, I mean, probably 20 bonus damage coming out for this. And we'll see what the last bans are, but I'm so excited. I want Midas Club Elite to do well, but also SG Esports are a team that I have the utmost respect for. I talked to you about this yesterday, how these Pain Gaming guys, essentially, they've been around forever. We've watched them multiple tournaments. Canada Cup is where I'm familiar with them as far. So I'm ready if SG can do it.
Aerocopter ban is an interesting one.
That is, that's not pretty common, but SG, they could definitely use it. It's going to be kind of a small AoE that the fights take place, and the cooldown would do a lot of work.
Yesterday, I want to say they picked the yesterday. Somebody picked the yesterday. I don't know who it was. An SA team definitely.
Oh, who made it through the bracket for SA? I didn't catch the last game.
Not today is in the grand finals currently, and then the winner of this series moved on to the grand finals as well.
Oh, nice. All right.
I thought Infamous was gonna at least get to here and then have a rematch with SG Esports.
Very surprising upset this morning.
Yeah.
I mean, we went into these qualifiers and or into the main playoffs, the double elim bracket. And if you remember, I said Midas Club can take a series off any of these teams, but like when they're at their best Dota, but I just didn't really expect it. The matchups definitely favored all three of the other teams, so very interesting to see. But both teams kind of mulling over this last pick. We'll see if this Venge ends up being core. At this point, levels are going to be very nice for the Venge against Clock, but that's not going to be the case.
It is not going to be.
I mean, maybe we're talking like offlane Jug Force.
Let's go. All right.
It's going to be
Jungle Juggernaut Venge. Is not actually that ridiculous considering it's SA.
Yeah.
They're very greedy. Like, we see the four position Clocks and Slaughter all the time, so. But I doubt that's the case here.
Yeah, you brought up a good point, though. That means SG Esports, until they get a blink on that Sand King, are going to have, you know, piss poor ganks.
What one position works here for Midas Club Elite?
Clark. Reserve time. Let's go super greedy.
I could see, actually. That could be okay. I'm trying to think of what else they could win the ones. They don't.
Terrible.
Yeah, terrible. I was thinking Terrorblade, but Sand King is. very good against Terrorblade. And generally speaking, in SA, they have a Dazzle behind their TB.
Yeah.
But there's so much frontline and counter initiation. Rock, Stampede, Hookshot. So Terrorblade is still a definite possibility for them here. It's good against the Juggernaut.
If they wanted to go like full armor, they could go for a Sven, but it seems like it would just be a little too right-clicky.
How do you feel about Morphling? Just for the Rubik's thinking.
Is it run anymore? I see a lot of Morphling.
Yeah, it's been picked like once in the playoffs. I feel like Sand King's a lot of damage for the Morph.
How's our audio level, by the way? When I took over Andrew's mic.
Let's check.
Okay. So yeah, Lashrak here is gonna need some farm. I mean, like, what are they doing with that?
He combos nicely with the clock. I just worry for his ability to get bursted. They need an early Yules against the TA and Jug. But I mean, yeah, I think Annie hit the nail on the head. It's this, the game for SG Esports, the linchpin is the Sand King. It's all on the Sand King. He can get a good early game. Which presumably, with the clockwork roaming around, he gets some space in his lane.
Yeah.
Wait, is there a chance this is a position one centaur and a support Lesh?
Yeah, there's a chance.
I was thinking,
because Lesh would be so good mid against TA.
Could they do like an aggro duel or tri lane with Lashrak and then have like the centaur state solo.
Yeah, but where does SF go? If
you can, I mean, I just think if Lashrak goes mid lane, he just pops an edict and then suddenly TA has no refraction.
Yeah, I mean, he needs coverage.
Draft overlay, Mott.
Yeah,
all right. God damn it, Mott.
In the morning,
it's very late at night actually for Annie. Whew. Again, game number one of a best of three here, lower bracket between SG and what's the other guys?
Midas Club.
I knew it started with Midas. I don't know, Midas Elite, Midas Friends. To be fair, Valve did a very interesting schedule here, so we're doing the playoffs of SA, but I've casted no SA games in this tournament, so.
That's why I just
there was some team that opened qualifiers, I think, that had like Midas Club, like somewhat elite or something like that as their name or something.
And Midas Club Elite is a thing, but I know it wasn't this thing.
Okay, so one position, Lashrak, because fucking Ace picked it up.
Yeah. It's a great name.
That was very Canadian.
Every game I've seen in SA so far has always started with a buzz. I think like they must.
Every game ever.
Welcome to my life, good sir.
It's like ridiculous. How many did you get? Oh, we got three. Okay, three to nine. Pretty good start. Pretty good start.
Yeah. So the one thing about this is, the other team has an advantage if they want to contest bounty runes or get vision down, because you have to have three heroes in the base, right? Clockwork. If he hits his own cogs, he denies them in one hit. So you need another hero to do that one hit for the SF. So it requires three heroes in your base, which is.
They're gonna do it again, trying up, and do it one more time.
Yeah, it obviously doesn't offset the benefit of having 14 souls, but it is a little bit annoying for the early game.
He's doing pretty
well. Yeah, it's pretty good.
He's gonna get up to
12.
Yeah,
can you get the
14 or 15? Is kind of the best usually you get out of the early game before you wanna at least scout out your bounty rooms.
Who's got a thing for iron branches?
King RD is just sitting there, and he's like, I'm still your rune.
I'm surprised. I've actually seen SG Esports do this before in these qualifiers. When this combination was on the other team, they sat on the high ground of the Dire side shop bounty rune and just killed the SF as soon as he walked up the hill to get the bounty rune. But I guess they figure that might be a little bit predictable now. But their level one is very good. So interesting to see them not consider that.
His 50 Necromastery stacks with the Necromastery and the Wraith Banny is plus 35 damage.
Jesus.
So he's feeling pretty good against the TA. The TA with Refraction.
Yeah.
Bonus damage is that 20.
I mean, he's going to get all the farm he wants. I don't think he'll be able to kill TA unassisted, but she's going to have a little bit of trouble there getting.
Yeah, the CS will definitely be in the SF's favor. There's the immediate smoke. So we talked about kind of the limitations of this gank duel, but maybe SF feeling very confident with the extra Necromastery stacks.
I think level one is where you can really get away with this. They bring the most damage there.
He's already, though, posturing over to the east, so.
Oh,
Trying to play safe. Oh, Rubick goes in, swirling around. They lift him up. They drop him back. Does TA have the damage? They get the body block here. One more shot will be the kill. It's going to be King RD that snaps it up. So early gold on the supports, too.
Man, that's crazy.
So, goodbye all his souls that he worked so hard for.
Yep, half of them down the drain.
He's got 8 at least, but still, that is rough. I mean, have 15 be able to see us that well. He does get back immediately, but it's a little bit.
Yeah, that's just half his damage gone. That's his money gone.
And innately, this matchup is DA favored, so. So, Annie, they do put the Centaur in the safe lane.
Woo!
Despite the one position player actually picking up the Leshrot. They're going to look to kind of pressure the Radiant safe lane and give Lelis, who is their offlaner, a good amount of farm here early, which is really nice for their lineup to get that front line as well as the Clockwork in, so they can kind of initiate two separately on two targets.
That's what I was talking about. Artis is gonna sit mid. It'll work.
Need some mana.
Yeah, if you come close, I'm gonna cog you. You better be ready. Just running out of
That's
right
pure South America right there.
Get out.
HFN, oh, you're in my lane? Let me just drop my item. See if you walk over to RZ.
So awesome, too. It's like that. Well, taunts
from it's like part of the culture.
Yeah.
In SA.
Nice. Ooh, Clock went with the cogs and Shadow Fiend got no souls off of them. Didn't get any denies.
Yeah, I mean, you can only really get one at this point because you need two hits from the SF.
Still just a little bit unfortunate here. He's lacking some damage, and as you can see, TA is starting to get her level. She goes for the two and Psyblades just to make sure that she can start shredding here.
Right, where's the Leshrac gone? I guess they figured they just can't apply much pressure to a Juggernaut, which is totally warranted. Ardo, he's going to run into Tavo here.
You got battery soul now. Yeah. Oh, the creeps.
I mean, he can just go.
Yeah.
The creeps. He does. He
yeah.
Be fine.
He's. I mean, he's.
He's kind of hanging.
Yeah,
around.
He's chilling
he
there.
A little long there.
Whew, all yeah, right.
Bardo might be in trouble.
Yeah, I guess
now.
He was trying to bait it, waiting for his Rubick.
The telekinesis.
Got him back down. Sater. Sater, come on, man.
Oh, the miss.
The miss comes out. Bardo.
Oh, highest caster.
King RD though, he's going back in. Does he have another fade bolt?
I thought it was such a cool play. Yes. Every time I see the uphill miss, I always get so excited.
I root for the true strike.
I do.
Oh wow, that raise.
Yeah.
It's been dangerous. HFN baiting him though, I guess. He's got, you know, other fractions.
They're going again now. Here comes King RD.
Oh, he's taunting in.
Yeah,
he's ready for this.
On the broomstick.
Yeah.
Get out of there, buddy.
Courier's right there. They're going to slap him back for now. But I feel like Shadow Fiend could definitely get a little more assistance here. He's got his Clockwork poking around. But, I mean, Rubick and Vengeful Spirit shouldn't be able to be this impactful right now.
He doesn't have the best TPing in here. I've seen a Clockwork Warlock duo, but. Definitely feels like that the Warlock could sit mid and throw a Shadow Word on the TA.
The good news is Sand King is not feeling too harassed. I mean, he got out of that little gank. He's having some good farm for himself right now. He's got four last hits, really bringing it home.
I mean,
and
Pedro's still doing very well CS-wise. He has 17 denies in his lane, so.
What's Hogs, but yeah.
Yeah, I mean, he's had the early death. Still doing admirably.
Well, I mean, the Jug is just free farming at this point. Is it going to happen here, or what? Let's get...
So 12 of those denies are
gone. No, 15.
Yeah,
he started with 15. And then he got one in mid lane, so okay, he got one creep deny.
MRP so, back.
It's all right.
I'm like, wow, what a champ. Oh, he's got 18 last hits.
Yeah. I mean, TA is just having a really easy time, and it's so dangerous, because Shadow Fiend, you know, he needs those kills to start scaling up and getting those souls. Meanwhile...
Yeah.
Oh, you got him.
That was a good try.
Good stamp, bro.
But that's not gonna work.
He got one of the radiant creeps low.
Frustration stop there.
Yeah. Like, son of a bitch.
I mean, this TA is so dangerous. And yeah, back to the point about the Shadow Fiend. If he wants to go dip into the jungle or go for other ganks to actually rotate and get his farm back to where it needs to be, he's leaving TA to go get a free blink deso by like 15 minutes.
Midas Club Elite or not? Planning on stalling either coming into this game. They wanted to assemble their five men, get, you know, assemble around the rock, the stampede, the centaur, which they plan on giving an early blink. Was able to have that initiation tool. So this is
what level's Clock?
A pretty big deal.
I think he's level 3 now. Yeah. They also have level 3 edict already for the Leshrac. So if they want to start trying to take down the towers, they can. A little bit later, I think. Yeah. Level 6 on Central Warner.
They need the stampede.
Yeah.
They can run the clock in, get a set of cogs off, and then the Leshrac dump some damage in. You can potentially transition that into an Edict Tower siege, but I mean, SG are getting all they want out of this early game. So if you have a Sand King Blink, you know, and they're extending under your tower with Stampede or Hookshot, easily kick them.
Oh. I mean, he can just keep doing that. There's not a whole lot of hard stun right now on Midas.
Even level 2, if he had level 2, but... Bam, batteries. Still, he almost gets Gale.
What level's Rubick?
4.
Yeah, so Radiant supports are getting a bit out of the early game. Leshrock 6, though. Warlock's been spending a lot of time in the jungle, so I'd assume he's 4. He's 4 at this point. Centaur's gonna be 6 momentarily. Oh.
Lesh can land this stun, it's gonna be big, but Burrow Strike gonna take him out of range, and now King RD comes in. This guy loves his taunt. They got the lift, the Warlock, he's done. He tries to TP out immediate bend missile.
The most optimistic TP I've ever seen.
I mean, you got it. You miss all the shots you don't take, I guess.
Yeah, it's a good attempt.
I'm gonna make it, guys. Oh god, there's a bang.
Oh god, no.
I caught a little too close to the tower.
TP in was even cancelled, whether it was from the TA or the Jug, I'm not sure, but they continue to farm in their lane, so...
The Warlock played that. I mean, I thought he had Rock. I know he was level 4, but it was like he was so aggressive, he was ready to like hide in the trees and drop it down in a nice radius, but then he just had nothing.
To some extent, that nullifies all the space he's got. Like Annie Thaler talked about, you know, the lack of support we've seen in the mid lane, speaking of which, there's 2 heroes.
TA? I mean, do they have any... Yeah. Oh,
oh
they got
God,
the sentry.
Actually, might have just saved your now. Oh. Has range for a million, so it's fine.
No, he double-edged the guy in front, and then it splashed a TA. Okay. But either way, yeah, double-edged has range for a million. Nice sentry ward, though.
Wow.
They anticipated the meld. Can they turn this around? One more hit. Rubick, dude. King RD. Holy mackerel. 5-0 on the Rubick.
He's a good player.
What's his level now? Does he have his 6?
Very close, too.
His favorite thing to steal, aside from Rock.
Stampede is nice. Other than that,
Beast Splitter, I don't know.
Cogs is like anti-synergistic with TA, so you don't really want to be using it. She has very low back range. Unless she picks up something like a Pike. Yeah, I feel like Centaur's whole toolkit is nice.
Still no hook on the clock, so TA can just kind of juke this around. She knows there's a sentry ward in the mid lane. There's 2 sentry wards in the mid lanes, but we'll just walk herself to freedom. She's having a pretty nice game so far. 52 last hits for her. Safe laners.
None of which are cogs.
Thank you, Debbie. Beautiful. Can we pop the network? Nice. Ooh, smoke up. Yeah, Jug's ready to go for the solo Omni Slash if he needs to.
Yeah, oh, this is like, I'm not walking.
Centaur is like asking for it if he walks into lane.
There's a Nat as well. Bardo, a little bit far forward.
He pulled the crew play.
Oh, if they can get the telekinesis though. King RD, he knows he's just styling. They're going to be bringing in the Leshrac here. Another Stampede to bring everyone forward. Looks like Warlock coming in. Yeah. Not going to have his ult.
Radiant got it. No, it's not denied.
That's so much gold, though. That's 500 gold to the Lesh.
Yeah, that's not something you want to give. He already has his full veil now, so that's pretty good. But Edge Pan's on, that's why.
Yeah, you're the only one that doesn't like Edge Pan. Everyone else turns it on.
What?
And they get mad at you for turning it off.
Yeah, I'm the only one here. Every other professional observer uses Edge Pan.
I definitely never Edge Pan.
That's like...
I'm with you, Mod.
It's the lazy way to do it.
I don't know if you would even try doing that. He's
oh, there we
that
go.
That was a good
right after he grabs the
kill. All right, here's my stance on Edge Pan. If you're just doing obs and your whole job is to focus on camera, don't use Edge Pan ever. Just middle mouse it. But if you also have to cast, sometimes you just need to slap the wrist around and also try to talk at the same time.
I'm going to disagree with you.
All right.
I'm going to stay neutral since I'm sitting in the middle. But I don't Edge Pan.
That was a great ensnare to Omni Slash Bro Strike at the Blade Fury on top. Jeez.
Come with the Dominator. Good item.
Warlock is like, well, I'm
Warlock's
really
chasing
anything,
the creep.
Man. What do you want me to do?
Oh, dude, Rangy's on him.
You damn whippersnapper.
Oh, can we get some cinematic on Rangy?
Oh, boy.
He's still
Edict
yeah,
as well.
Still
oh, look at that raise. He did a lot.
Jeez. SGR now feels.
Oh, good. Man, he walks into the telekinesis. They already popped the trap, but look at this. Oh, no.
You know, yeah, some of this you can definitely attribute to sloppiness on Midas's part, but this is more the SG we were accustomed to seeing in the group stage.
Yes.
A lot of good coordinated movement. They're still attaining some sort of greed across the map. Like Sand King, he's barely been active aside from that Centaur kill. So he's been able to get a lot out of the jungle. Meanwhile, they're winning the early game decisively across the map. So very good play thus far overall. And their lineup is, you know, TA is almost the epitome of a snowball hero. So very
hard. She's definitely got the start she needs. She's not in her Blink Dagger just yet, but she'll get there after a couple more camps.
This is something we haven't seen much in 2017. Ancient stacking.
Oh my.
Well, it's because they spawn every like 45 minutes.
Yeah, right. And there's four camps now as opposed to the field two. So I guess same across the map, but there's a lot more attention paid certainly before 7.0 on ancient stacking.
Okay. So, alright, SG, they're starting to try to take over map control here. You can see they're kind of on the opposite side of the river. You can have a tier over tie both top, both mid as well. So they're going to get wards down, maybe farm a little bit more. They have the blink now. If they want to make a smoke play, they can. If they also have the blink too on top, but they just got both of those blinks. This is a really good time.
Yeah, this is where they need to make the moves.
They're very strong right now.
But Avenge, she's got shoes.
The thing is, too, they've got all the tier ones already here, sub 12 minutes. So
played Avenge game yesterday and had 1,000 net worth of like.
Oh, Suns fan would be pleased. Centaur went for 35 damage over the 2 mana regen.
Oh, nice.
Sometimes he's got to hit harder.
And he's not really using his stomp that aggressively. He's just really farming up and.
There must be, right?
Oh, top lane. A deep dive in. Clockwork going to be hiding from the cogs, but Burrow Strike in. They got the telekinesis if they need. There's a Centaur bopping around, going for the stomp. They get the lift. They're just stacking stuns on stuns. The rock drops. Juggernaut not going to be able to find the kill onto Bardo. He's still alive. Magic Missile finishes the job. The Vengeful Spirit, she's shooting in and Stampede. They might be able to find a lot of return kills here. Venge now on the run. She's got herself a TP, but it'd be brave to try to go for it now.
Feels like a bit of hubris from SG's side. They don't commit as five. They just got the Blink Dagger from their Sand King. I think they're strongest as a unit, and PA not nearby. They just lacked the damage.
Oh, yeah, well, there's the damage.
She did have a DD, so a little unfair, but not having the TA there really hurt them. The Omni Slash soaked up a lot.
Blinks back up.
Yep, she's
freaking dead.
Literally two shots.
DD Melt Strike, two shots to get the kill.
That's before Deso.
That was looking actually so good because of the Warlock Golem from Redis Club Elite, and then he just stays alive somehow and kills like four people.
Yeah, it felt like the Golem soaked up two of the three Omni Slash jumps as well, so ADR. Really nice timing on the Golem to save, at least for the moment, the Clockwork on Midas Club Elite, but it still feels like for the Radiant, things were salvaged. The TA cleaning up on the back end. Overall, Midas Club, you can't unhappy with that.
Hitting the jug was huge. Now I think for SG, if you want to wait maybe a couple more seconds and then get some going, now that Warlock Golem is down for 6 seconds, might be time. Or you can just keep farming Desolator first for TA.
And she's going to be melting towers when she gets that up. You tap into chat to make sure there's no glaring audio issues. So paranoid.
Okay. We're good.
All right, great. Boy, Shadow Fiend. I mean, his net worth is feeling a little bit flimsy. He couldn't rotate to find anything. Hasn't been able to dip into.
Just being mean. That's funny. Anyway, they're gonna get the kill on Jack. This is a game that. I get him, like I said yesterday, he had 1,000 net worth game on Venge Spirit. Should go very well.
Mm. At least it's not a core Venge. They're in. Oh, missed Burrow Strike, and it looks like there is going to be a hook shot into the clock to try to follow up. Top nice stun, though. Leshtrak is able to pummel down the Sand King.
Yeah, TA's top lane, so. Yeah. Should be all she wrote.
He is completely fine with this Juggernaut. He's still sitting back. He's got himself an Omni Slash if anyone pushes too far in. And his tower is starting to get low. Warlock Golem still down, but Shadow Queen.
HFM low on mana in tower range. Needs to be careful.
That was very interesting.
Like, don't do that. Not in tower range.
Hasn't gotten the TA in a while. It's been banned a lot, so.
Yeah.
Maybe it's just a bit of.
I mean, maybe she was going for like the play where he TP's in and then she just two shots him with the Meld Strike.
Yeah. Certain, but yeah, under the tower.
You know, it's she. You miss the shots, you don't take them.
Hey, that's the theme of the game so far. It's So Dire looking a lot better than they did just moments ago. Again, though, these last two engagements that they've taken have benefited them. Absence of the TA. So see if HFN kind of groups up more often with his team. Still feeling really good, though, about where he's positioned. ADR, a little bit less scary. But Deso is completed now.
Yeah, whose medallion was that?
I think it was the Vengeance.
Yeah. Love early medallion. It's like you had armor at one point.
Wave of Terror, Deso, Meld Strike.
If they get one pick, they can take Roshan. They might even just do without.
I mean, it's going to take TA like six shots.
I want to make sure.
They do have Rock Up and Stampede, so they're definitely willing to fight.
Have you seen a hookshot this game? I don't think so. They are smoking into Rosh. Yeah, this is going to go real fast. If they flare it again. Or no.
There it is.
Don't miss it.
It's going to be late, bro.
Don't miss it. That is a quick roach. It's a 16-minute roach.
That's just after like 10 seconds. It's too fast.
That's just a whelp from the Dire side.
I mean, they like kind of saw it going on. They're like, all right, I guess we kind of push bottom now, where it's the farthest away from the danger.
Here we go. This is the push timing. Mm. You got Deso up. You got he's got Yasha. No Manta yet.
All right, Pedro. Let's see if you're gonna be brave soul. I was looking for.
Oh, that scan actually, they found him with a
nice
Centaur.
Centaur on Centaur hate.
HFN needed to get in there a little bit quicker, stop that blink going. Pedro might get there.
Blink's still on cooldown though. Saving grace for now. He's gonna be whittling down the tower, and Centaur is ready to go in for the for the blink comp stomp. But
he's trying to wrap and punt the back line here.
Very dangerous fight.
I mean, they are staying relatively clumped up. A really nice blink in the map. Rock, there we go. Gonna catch out onto two. The hook shot is gonna catch out the Ven from the back line. She can't go. She can't swap her teammates. She can't save herself. She's trapped in by the ledge stun. Gonna be swapping herself forward. I guess trying to keep the Dire occupied as they're now gonna keep their roll going. But oh my. Everyone is just melting so
fucking
slow.
Oh my god, his Pulse of actually did so much work there.
It did, but now Tia's coming back. She'll be at full health, full mana. He wants to get the job done. Look at that. Ray shot, no!
Alright.
Still a good fight for the Dire right now.
They got the Psionic Trap, and now Clockwork has literally no mana. They're just gonna be dragging him down. Getting with the food a little bit. He dominated Siege Creed. Keep going.
Big in front? Yes. I like your style, HFN. I don't even care if you die. You're definitely dead, but it was worth it, dude.
No, he's
not
fine.
Worth at all.
He's fine.
Not worth at all.
He's fine.
This is terrible.
Oh,
that's just falling apart.
It's only 700 gold going to the last track. No, wait. 1,000 with the kill on the Rubik. Wait, no. He gets more gold. All right, so 1,300 gold for the last track. All right,
so I want to go back to that mid lane fight. Basically, what happened is, first of all, lovely three-man rock, whereas SG were not posturing up to initiate. They were just kind of glancing blow, make sure and get out with Sandstorm, and Rock hits on three, but Bardo hookshots just above the tree line and cogs the TA completely out of the fight. So TA unable to do any damage in the beginning, then she kind of just uses her Aegis on the back end once her back line was already dead.
Yeah.
So they've been unable to counter initiate for their TA. They use the Burrow Strike to go in, they initiate on the Rubick with the Centaur, and then the Venge and TA with the clock. So there's really no saving grace for the TA. This TA needs to get in the front
line. And when they did initiate with the Burrow Strike, the Latrak was like right under the tower too, which I thought was also not that great. So they were being a bit too aggressive trapped, and they just needed to sit back and just see the rest of the tower.
It was like overconfidence. Yeah. I mean, look at the net worth.
I mean, that fight happened right as Latrak got his Bloodstone too, so that thing has some charges.
Other items are out there. Take a look.
I mean, TA can boost up a Dragonlance, which is nice now, so that she can actually right-click into the cogs, but
really full force on the Shadow Fiends and hold off just with the Dragonlance and then pick up a damage item or a BKB in between. I guess he needs that mobility, needs to be able to keep some distance between himself and TA.
I agree, though, it's peculiar having a Stampede on his side for him to go. But it's 2600, 2350 plus the 300 gold that could have gone in.
All right, we got to pause. Get you ahead.
Oh, yeah, I'll have to take a second sometimes. Not you, Mott.
No.
You well-oiled machine.
Yeah. Making me look inefficient here. Mister, I slept 9 hours and I'm complaining.
Well,
I don't know if I've slept 9 hours the whole hub.
The two nights.
Yeah, it's pretty accurate.
The two nights before that, I've been busy and didn't fall asleep before the block. So I finally get some sleep. I think I'll take it. I don't care if I don't sleep the rest of the time.
You won't. I think the last 48 hours, it's been like 5 total hours of sleep.
Yeah, Annie, you're actually nuts.
I'm a little bit.
I've been trying to convince you to go to bed.
I can't. I gotta do work.
Just gotta play Zelda.
No. So good.
Cast the shitload of Dota first. Yeah. But then play a little Zelda.
It's like 2 10-hour Dota shifts. Gotta do the hotel work, and then I gotta play Breath of the Wild.
Hey,
like,
2 10-hour Dota shifts is better than no Dota shifts. Let
exactly.
me tell you.
All right, we're finally back. Let's go. Oh, I think they're gonna be chilling for a while. I guess she's gonna do anything too crazy.
Is the Aegis time on? Nope, she's you lost her.
Yeah,
that's right.
But she's not up for a long time.
Yeah.
So TA has Illis in her quick buy. I really feel like you need a BKB this game.
Yeah.
Especially the way the fights have been going for Leshrac, it feels like he's just going everywhere. Bless you.
Sorry. Derailed you a little bit there.
God, that was just a good exclamation point. Let me bring it home.
Here we go. Fight going in.
Next, they have a hook shot as well. Nice swap away. They are going to find the stun. Oh, hook shot is going to whiff to the south, so they'll just settle for the veg.
Keep that vision. That was rough.
You want to bottom?
Can I kill him? He's pretty tanky.
He looks pretty dead to me, Mott. Oh, no. They're going to leave him.
They can't kill him.
The Leshrac was too scary. If one TP's into the shrine now, TA's isolated here. He's gonna get stunned up, and it looks like he's gonna take a lot of damage. Refraction now down. She's gonna try to cut apart Bardo, take everyone down with her. She's got the psionic trap with the retreat, gets 2 heroes slowed, but still loses her life.
Across the map, 3-for-1. Going to the Midas. ADR.
Godlike. That's fucking it.
Yeah, he's got everything going his way.
Why don't we see more carry Lesh if this is what can do?
Yeah, I mean. I don't know. I feel like this is oversteps from SG and hubris from them a lot. That's kind of put the Leshrac where he is. But he's definitely really effective this game. So ADR with a heads up play. He knows they TP'd bottom. So he takes the tier 2 top lane, which is very tiny silver lining for his lineup. But things are spiraling out of control for them.
The net worth is still even. It's not like a lost game. TA still got plenty of farm. Problem is Juggernaut seems to be lagging behind. And I feel like we've seen that so much this tournament across multiple reasons. This Juggernaut is still really prioritized, but he just doesn't seem to have as much of an impact as other carries we're seeing.
Okay.
Tough. I was posturing on me to engage, but
I thought he would go on that.
They have no vision of any other heroes on the map. Purple top lane, so. But it felt like they could jump.
With the Shadow Fiend coming in, they're going to try to make an attempt. Shadow Fiend really brings that damage, and he got on him. In terms of items, to pick up. Ooh, that's a nice choice.
Yeah, I like it too. He's not going to have an MKB.
Hey, Zayori. What's up, man?
Allows the Lesh and the SF to both be building together.
What was our audio?
Don't
Why are you trying
don't
to
make
the
any
chat,
paranoid
dude?
Stuff?
No, dude, you gotta keep the chat open just so
they're
can just, yell at you in the audio.
They're trolling you
wrong.
The entire time.
No, they're not.
Yes, they are. I've been looking at the audio. They're saying you're too loud when you're actually we're super quiet and I had to turn you up. Of course they're trolling you.
No,
come
but
on.
Sometimes there's a muted and you're like, oh shoot.
Well, we're in the middle of the game. It's not gonna happen now.
Sometimes there's like random white noise that happens. You gotta be aware
there's
of this.
There's Dota happening.
No, there's not.
Oh, they live together. Some.
Yeah, that's true.
Very different opinions on certain things.
Except Zelda. That is where the common ground.
Yeah, dude,
really,
I will bow down to
you.
Mott bought the Switch for the house. Thumbs up for Mott.
Play that game for sure. What BKB? I think I'm gonna watch it.
Not as good purchases.
I don't know what it is.
Well transitioned, Danny. Very well.
Finally getting the BKB. As you guys have mentioned, he was going to go Daedalus, and I think that was probably the better option.
So this is the first time we're seeing this. This made a huge lead that they had earlier. He actually smoked as a full unit. See if they're coordinated enough to kind of
get this position.
Facilitate their TA's aggression with the sanctions.
Oh, dumping down the damage. They blow up the Leshrac. They're going to blow up the Shadow Fiend as well. Swap back in under the tower. The rock is dropped. Can they still finish off the Shadow Fiend? He goes down with the Death Rush, him doing so much damage. The Venge is out. Clockwork can be finished off with him. He isn't his own cog. Buyback. Oh no, it's just a Bloodstone on the left back, but now he's back in the fight. The Pulse Nova doing a ton of damage. Centaur, he's so tanky with the Crimson Guard. That's what they're doing. They just come back in and they destroy everyone. Templar Assassin tries with all her might to finish off the Lash, but they can't do it. And it's just going to be Juggernaut versus the world here. He's playing Ring Around the Rosie, and it looks like he's actually going to get out alive.
Oh man, they were so close to getting that splitter too.
And we finally saw kind of the combination from the Dire when they actually get the jump come to fruition, but what heads up, like good communication from Midas, calm and collected. I'm still dropping the rock. My two cores just died because I know he's going to respawn instantly and travel back in.
Yeah.
And
he lost his gold. They'll pulse him, but they died so quickly. Questionable.
They're scared of the Venge. They're not going to be able to.
Yeah, that actually is huge. You need to go way further.
All right. They'll trade Centaur for that. Sure.
Yeah.
Out for the first time in the game, might have been able to get 1400. Or I think it was a 1400 net worth advantage for the Radiant.
Yeah, it was about
that
the,
last fight.
Yeah.
So this is.
They do get the tower as well, so 1000 is about that. 1000 of that net worth is all off the back of that engagement. Here one is still up.
Yes.
A gold. That's in addition to whatever they gain.
Shadow Fiend, I mean, if you just. Oh.
Slow into the blade.
Hit Roach is gonna melt once again. Negative armor strat is doing its thing. Dire. Are they gonna flare this? Do they know what's going on?
Yeah.
It's more a question of does everyone else survive to be there for the second life? That just seems not to be the case for the original engagement mid lane with the first stages, but SG seem undeterred despite losing this engagement top lane. It'll at least give them a small window to farm. ADR is completely up with the engagement lane.
Yeah, like, ADR seems to fall so quickly in a lot of these fights. I feel like way quicker than you imagine and Jug would go down, but...
I've been calling him 40R for like 3 years.
Yeah,
you can do both, I think. It's probably fine.
Yeah, so the reason I call him ADR is the player's name's Adrian. And Kat on the team also has a 4.
Yeah,
name,
that
so
would
I
make sense. No, I mean, it's just one of those things you don't know
speed.
Unless someone explains it to you.
Yeah.
Oh, Flappy.
PETA. Someone called PETA.
Oh.
PETA.
You're so funny.
Come
about
on, guys. Race the memes. This is Dota 2.
That joke would be a hell of a lot better if I'd slept in the last 36 hours. All right, Midas from Bardo going in, getting that efficiency. You know, what's he working on? Okay. Debated.
They gotta get out.
Yeah. They gotta leave. That forced to TP from the Shadow Fiend, I guess.
Haha.
That was their end game.
Be into the shrine, but it was a long duration one. Clock looking for a hug. He just landed a blind one. He throws out a flare. That's fine. Then he'll land it.
That's
no
the
one
you need
either.
To get out. They got the Stampede though, they're all wrapping around. Can they get the Split Earth? They get the Yules up into the air. They're gonna follow it up with the stun, but she's gonna BKB just in time. Pop the Psionic Trap to get the slow. None of her teammates can get there. They're just running as fast as they can. The Crimson Guard popped out. Another Psionic Trap to hold the Centaur back in. Now, did Centaur go too deep here? The Radiant, they're gonna try to salvage this. Oh, another Blink Initiation coming forward. Fucking A gonna be going, trying to get the Stomp off. He gets two heroes stuck.
Wow.
Oh, no!
Stolen rock, but...
He stole the rock. I don't know if it's enough. It's gonna be enough, though. ADR is trying. He can't even break down the Warlock.
Oh!
This has been out. And now they're gonna kill the...
No!
A again, she's gonna go down. The Epicenter's too late. Yule Scepter, there's a Fable, at least gets one kill out of this, but Tavo's gonna go down next. Hellas is going in with these Stomps. He helps get the kill on Tavo. Dear God.
That just felt unnecessary.
What is happening in South America?
I don't know. I feel like Juggernaut really should have kept him in his sights.
Hey guys, why is Mott trying to cosplay a tiger?
I really like the animal, guys. Leave me alone. It's my favorite.
That was good.
Hard.
Wow, Mott. You got him.
I'm a great tiger.
What's your best cat now?
No.
Kind of the response I was expecting.
I was definitely not going to do that.
Press one if Mott doesn't know how to have fun.
It was a good attempt.
I don't have any more coffee. It's going to be a very long cast. Alright, Shadow Fiend. I mean, he's... He and Scotty together. I'll have it in a couple more hundred gold. But is that the solution to their problems? Is that how they close this out and take high ground? Still feels like he's vulnerable in these fights if he's isolated.
Yet to be the case, though. You just, you know, with the clock in the front lines and the stampede. I don't know. What the immediate steps are for the Radiant. It feels like they got so much out of the early game, and their supports are still very farmed, but they're just having much less of an impact than their counterparts. Roxanne is really good. It's like Venge and Rubick are just one step behind where they need to be.
It's the good news is that Juggernaut's keeping pace with the TA now. I mean, we've had him feel a little bit less impactful in the early fights, but he's shaping up once he got his manta and working on.
He just picked up the blink in addition to the defusal. Maybe, you know, we saw him with the slight inability to kill off the backline. Maybe in this next engagement he's able to hop right on Warlock. Warlock has Glimmer Cape at this point. Yeah. So still a difficult kill.
He lived with the amulet, like just the amulet fade in that last fight, so see if they're going to be able to close it out. I mean, high ground can be pretty difficult. Sand King always has that threat of just burrow strike into the epi. Avenge can swap you a little deeper than you'd like to be. It's all about isolating Dire from their team. They want to be wadded up. They want to have that safety bubble. Got to be in the Crimson Guard AoE in order to live through this.
So. Yep, very strong together, not so much. Really, I mean, Leshrog. Up, you know, the extra health from the Bloodstone. Ow, but Kashifa's on top of you.
He's pretty farmed.
So let me take that back. Gold. Even isolated, he's pretty tanky at this point.
And you kill him once, he's still gonna spawn pretty quickly.
1500 gold
charges
as well.
It's like he is farmed. You get an X on a zero.
Octarine, if you want to be a stupid head.
I guess you can go BKB if he really wants to play it safe.
He doesn't need
me. I think Octarine's enough. Yeah. He can just leave his Pulse Nova on in fights now.
Gonna try to do this ADR switch with his bottom. He's got some guys behind him. Epi now has Scotty on. They are very farmed.
He could just get bots too to kind of pick up with the clock, but it seems like they're content to stay together for the most part. I'm setting up top lane, but everyone is doing this.
Oh, they got the scan. They know he's there. There's going to be the spin to finish the TP. You guys, you can start spinning while you're TPing. It doesn't cancel you.
Look at that. Was looking. They all
really
TP
like
to the shrine.
That was put
way
into the game. Like
they all TP the
Mal,
shrine.
The Shikuchi. Mm-hmm. Do those kind of effects.
Getting a lot of damage at the start because they all TP.
But yet you switch treads and like, oh, gotta stop to fucking buckle my shoes. Like, I hate that.
Any trigger.
I've done that
Ice
so
Rock,
much.
Please.
I've swapped to int so many times to make my TP more efficient and it just doesn't work. Oh, you think I'd learn after like the seventh time?
Half damage and power from the Sand King. He just walks up there and hits it casually.
Good
yes,
joke.
Yeah, yeah.
It was a good joke.
Yeah, that's the Twitch meme.
Alright, Sevi.
I thought I was going to say it was outdated, but apparently not.
We had to wait 5 minutes to confirm.
Feels good.
Yes, joke was funny. Very good.
Alright, so Centaur, putting little Aggies to work, and he's going to be finishing off his
Rutrow, Aghanim, Centaur.
He's already had it, yeah, he's got his next little thingy.
Play, guys. I think
is he getting road. Two plate mails? Because it feels like it.
Salt Kiras, I guess?
I mean, but, oh yeah, there we go. Just had a second plate mail queued up. I'm like, yeah, you
good
can
item.
You could just build up some raw armor,
it is,
sir.
It is really a good item. Yeah, they already have a Shivas at this point.
Oh, he's going
so
to
So AC is good.
That is going to be
good. I definitely agree with the AC choice.
Get that going. Alright, it's BKB time now, apparently, for...
Did Rubick still have Rock and just throw these, or
he probably did.
Yeah, I mean, you want to just burn that while you can.
Alright, so... Just kind of making the essential comeback steps. They can put Gem, and then Knife, any aggressive.
Oh, yeah, that's TP.
I feel like they're so capable of just running down a lane at this point.
The lanes are getting pushed out pretty well by SG. They're making sure that everything's pushed in past the river so that Midas would have to come back and deal with those. Not only that, but they also have to keep Roshan on their mind. Yep. Pretty soon.
TA switched off the Daedalus mindset at this
point. Nope. It's in her backpack.
She finished with the BKB, though. It's good. Oh, we saw that
bottom. It's doing a lot of work in her backpack there.
You don't
need the TP right now, I guess.
You can get out of there.
You really gotta have that dragon.
I was gonna say, Dragonlance clearly better.
I feel like Daedalus might be a little more stats efficient, but we can check with Purge to confirm later. Oh, there we go, finally.
Oh. Yeah, so BKB for the Lash, safe. I think safer than the Octarine. Octarine helps with the bots too, so I would have liked to see it as well, but.
Might get it. I mean, he's still gonna get it. Now he's gonna get Hex next, actually.
Why not?
With an Ogre Club, casual Ogre
they're
Club.
They're bumping in. I mean, what's Venge gonna do?
Magic like, missile gotcha. See
like,
later.
She's gonna poke him and then take like 5 out of 4 damage with return
what's
and then
up?
Just die.
Wanna fight?
Yeah.
I didn't think.
She wants to fight. Too bad all of the heroes are just triangulating on her.
No. She didn't want to guarantee
it. Yes, Rubik is having an okay game.
Yeah.
Chinese BKB.
Yeah.
Got him.
It's BKB.
Oh, he swapped his slots.
It wasn't even the
BKB
Chinese one
because
it was 9 seconds. I wasn't even testing to see if it was working.
It's all right.
You know,
not like this.
I've done that. I can empathize. You try to click to drag slots.
The hardest thing to do
click.
Is to not be triggered when you do that.
Yeah, you got to keep
stay
your composure.
Calm, yeah.
And
all right, guys. Don't worry. It's back up in like 50 seconds.
Yeah, so Teyvo may be looking to cut the wave here just because they don't have a BKB, but.
They are pushing in pretty. I mean, this bottom lane has been pushed in towards the tier 3 tower for like most of the last 10 or so.
When are we gonna push?
Roche in a minute. I think.
Like, I feel like when it started out like
asking
really
the
slow,
real question.
And then it got real high octane real quick, and then just
let's
just sit back and farm for 45 more minutes.
Creep to a stop. So that, you know, that's what I was saying to you at the beginning of you starting SA yesterday is we get. Two things in SA, it's either unbridled aggression or just a farm fest. And for whatever reason, teams don't seem confident enough with their advantage. So I guess, you know, the next apple of the eye of both of these teams will be Roche, but yeah, it definitely felt like Midas were so much stronger. They do pick up the BKB on SF now, though, in immediate smoke. So
they really wanted to get a pick and then be able to go over to Roche. But they can get
more. Right, they'll find the bench.
That's unfortunate.
That's a bit
it's
of,
not the worst thing in the world.
He's
still going to die. He's still going to die.
Efficiency, though.
What that does mean is that both players with some really cat-like reflexes, both instantly onto the bench. One with the Yules, one with the snap.
Cat-like reflex. Was that on purpose?
No pun intended.
Okay, well there it is.
Oh yeah, and I'm the furry. All right.
Listen, you can't tell me not to bring up that meme and then bring it up yourself. All right.
Can I just clear everything up for people watching? Because I got a lot of PMs of like bad shit. I'm not actually a furry.
Don't lie to them, Annie.
No. I mean, live and let live, but I'm not about it for me. Either way, I mean,
respectable.
Radiant, they see what's going down. They had a sonic trap in the pit, but they couldn't do it. So, how do you kill the Shrek now? He's a big boy.
Well,
probably don't.
You don't. He's got BKB. If he just had Yules, they still have a Diffusal Blade for it, but he's got Aegis BKB. I don't think you try.
They're calling you Freddy Krueger.
Yeah. I'll come into your nightmare and I'll deal with all of you.
Oh Jesus, that's really scary. Mott and I see.
I never made that connection. Leave it to Twitch chat to make that connection.
Listen, I will fuck you up in your dreams.
It is.
I have to sleep in the room next to Mott for the rest of my life.
We are in Denver. These are Broncos colors.
Yeah, it's a football.
Listen, I. Literally just threw on whatever was in my next to my bed. I came home. I didn't even unpack. What do you want from me, you freaking people? Get out of here.
I just want to play your Switch. That's all I need.
That's tight, man. I wouldn't do you like that, Mott.
You're too funny. All I want to do is go. Get me out of here.
Get me out. So, Hex, only about 1,200 gold away for this flesh rock. And we know he farms fairly quickly, so maybe even within the duration of this Aegis has a Hex. Super scary. And even if he can still kind of forego buyback, he's got 19 Bloodstone charges, so even if the Aegis expires, All right, mid lane. They did just see the Lash bottom, and he TP's in.
I mean, this tower is just melting.
Tower.
I mean, they're going to fort for this, but that's going to last for, what, a couple seconds of freedom, and then to Rubick to make the play.
If we have another 12 seconds for Edict to be back up.
Can I just have Centaur sit there and soak? Oh, there we go. Nice initiation. They've isolated the Lesh track, which is going to be Golems dropping out the Radiant there on the run. This could be somewhere from the Juggernaut. They're activating the Shrine to try to keep themselves up, but they can't reinitiate here. The Rats, they are just melting down. It's like there is going to be Effie dodged out by the Yules. Bardo gets really low. There's a Requiem by the Shadow Fiend just trying to collect some souls, but it's like no one's going down on the side of the Radiant.
Very
Dire,
well played.
They go in, they get a tier 3, they get racks, and they lose pretty much nothing.
I mean, as soon as the melee racks goes down, Pedro Hurricane pikes himself out, and not even necessarily in an anticipatory nature for the epicenter, but he ends up taking no damage from it because of it. The Lash still holding the Aegis. It felt like they could have killed the Aegis off, but they just didn't commit hard enough there.
Right, yeah.
At the beginning, I think ADR even maybe had a DD room.
I thought they were going to kill with the epicenter.
I mean,
too.
The thing is, if.
Yeah, if you do
hindsight's
commit.
20/20. If you commit and then accidentally get 5-man wiped and done on buybacks, that's
lose.
GG. And again, this is the last chance to qualify for Kiev in SA. You gotta make it through. If you drop down, that's it. No second chance.
I mean, you know, you kill the Aegis, you don't really gain much.
But I will say, I think Midas Club Elite, they can wait till the Golem is back up, maybe, if they want to go again, keep the waves pushed out, but there's not much SG can do. Like, it's only 11,000 net worth advantage, but it's just like,
feels
like
the
past like 30 minutes have been nothing, really nothing.
Positioning's just generally been very good. They played the Clockwork well, they've counter-initiated with the Rock very well.
Last time they got a kill was on Bard, 31 minutes. That's how bad this game has been going for it.
I mean, your TA had 9k net worth. Like,
why did the TA just drop off a cliff?
Yeah.
Like, what happened?
It was positioning, really. She didn't do any damage in the first three full-scale fights, two of which she wasn't present, and then the one in the mid lane where the clockwork cogs her out of it. So, yeah, she just didn't get anything done. ADR just didn't have enough damage.
Oh, my
Pocket
God.
Flare may have scouted.
Oh, my God. He just missed it. He just missed that hook shot. The right.
That's some deforestation going on. Look at that thing.
These trees are already dead, though. They're dire.
Well, I mean, they're home to the bats and the
dead
millipedes
inside.
And the. You're taking away some precious habitats for the dire snakes.
Ah, they're fine.
Find a new home. I mean, they can just take over the Radiant side when the game's over, right? Rough. Rough stuff. There's always that third agent. Slacks.
Slacks is third agent.
Let's not get into that.
Find a new planet, alright.
He was really defeated day one when he had that like 5-minute monologue and he was muted for the whole thing.
The entire time.
So the guy that, whoever audio corrected it, thumbs up to you. He sat there smiling. He was listening to that, his words were not lost.
Somebody put like that much time into unmuting Slacks.
Dota 2, man, it's a community.
Yeah, just for future reference, don't invest time into Slacks' memes. It's not worth it. There's no return for that.
You're a brave soul. We appreciate your efforts.
Yeah, we truly do. Alright, here we go, the push cap now. We're gonna go again.
Lift onto the left. Can they isolate him here? He's taking some tower shots. Whirl strike to hold him in place. There is going to be a stomp to zone. There's a stolen stomp
still
now. Rubick can reinitiate here. Hook shot in. Bardo isolates the TA and the cog. He's going to BKB. Not going to get clipped by the stun, but there's going to be the upheaval. Golem dropped in. That's
steal.
A stolen golem.
That's actually a 6 steal. It might not be enough.
It's
though.
Nice, but is it going to be enough to hold everyone in place? Is Requiem's coming out? The Dire, they're getting low, but they're still fighting.
Oh, the cheese.
Okay, Leshrac, just that's a big screw. The sheep stick to lock him down. TA's Dunzo immediately buys back. Hook stomp comes in from the Centaur. Tavo trying to get him down, but no.
Centaur was at 1 HP and not a single jump of the Omni went.
Yeah, that Warlock just man fought and then King RD Rubick. Oh, this team. Oh, we had Gura shake back up. Oh, so close.
They can't see him. There we go.
So they
buy back on TA.
Did they not get any racks?
They got the tier 3 and they got some damage in the melee.
I mean, I would call that roughly successful.
It's a
they do call the buyback from the TA.
Yeah, that was
Nice steal on the rock. I mean, Rubick steals it.
He's an aggro.
ADR really playing well around his limitations. QD Tommy class is like less than 10% HP. But he got a little bit unfortunate. He didn't end up killing the center.
What are we laughing at?
Nothing.
Oh, my shirt. Yeah, I'm proud of it too, guys. Thanks.
You know, it's better than my sweater. This is Tidehunter TI 3.5.
It doesn't have stripes on it. Mine does.
Mine doesn't have stripes on it? Mike, get fucked. It has stripes.
Yeah. They look like stripes to me.
Yeah, they're pretty stripes.
They're kind of curved, though.
There's more accurate tiger stripes, dude.
Yeah, zebras have curves.
Bam. All right, hookshot in. They got the hex going down. The swap in. Ben's going to give her life to keep her.
Yeah, she's just going to die.
I mean, TA comes back in anyway, so how effective was the
so
swap,
is TA.
Really?
Oh, boy.
Oh, lordy, lordy.
Yeah, you're dead. Mega dead. That's dieback.
Hey,
okay.
The gold goes to the centaur, though.
Probably going
to
be getting.
This looks a lot like 6.8, whatever, where Left Rock was.
Really
the
good.
One where lightning made me want to die.
TP mid. All right, time to push, guys. They're gonna just try to finish the TM off here.
No buyback on the TA, so this is gonna be difficult to say the least.
Why isn't Jug doing
it? He's
anything?
Going for it. He's going for the epicenter, and he actually hits it on it too. This might be huge.
Omni.
That's
Omni as well. They just went too hard. Oh, yes, the BKB, the record's gonna come out. He's still taking damage. Nice use of that Blade Fury, but still, they have to run now. Oh, ADR, Scotty, that's not good. The man to dodge actually was so huge.
He has the healing ward up. He can reinitiate here.
Oh, but Tavo's just gonna eat it.
Yeah.
Shrine? Oh, I gotta hit that shrine off.
That was a
off.
Sick force into fucking hookshot. That was crazy. He actually just slid right into it.
All
right,
buyback from the Rubick. He's here to save the day.
He'll be up in 3.
150
Flash,
attack
though, up in 20 seconds.
20 seconds, and he hits spots. He buys back. He's like, I'm just gonna help him up now. The perfect time for them. They've used everything. They have 2 heroes down. They're gonna use some tracks. They're gonna try to get 3 in. Lelis is actually gonna die here. He's now left alone.
ADR in trouble though. It's TP inbound as well. He's in a corner.
Good stampede.
They get the
steal.
Stampede steal with the
they
rock.
Hold them in place. The shrine, it's up. It's doing its work, but.
What?
Oh, that's
on the other
that's
team.
Like a legit disconnect.
That's on the other team. I
all
right. Was gonna be on,
looks like Centaur's pretty confident his team can end this one out.
All right, guys, go to extra 5 and got this.
BMDC. Because he died, right?
That's an aggressive
he doesn't
TV.
Even get to, like, bask in
no,
the
literally,
victory.
He's died. He's done. He's like, all right, team, just fucking, I'm going to go drink some coffee. You guys take care of this.
And it's not uncommon for the losing team in SA to DC, so that was kind of surprising
I
was
that
it like, was the...
I thought it was actually going to be SG just leaving the game, but no.
So, oh, there he's apologizing. I'm sure that was unintentional.
Yes. You're going to take all 3 of them, right?
Beginning of the end.
All right, let's see how many seconds it takes from unpaused to
SG. You're going to fight the bitter end.
We're at like 10. Oh, Ben stunned yourself, and that's just...
Feels bad.
That was a great double bro strike.
It was, but they bring in nothing else.
Yeah, still no
up.
TA for 10 seconds.
Why isn't Juggernaut... I mean, he's trying here, but he's just not having an impact with another 4 hits.
Cancel right. TP.
This is pretty huge. He's only got 11 Bloodstone charges.
He bought back,
Shadow
by the way.
He's still coming forward. The BKB, though. Oh, they just melt down Tavo. Looks like Rubik's going to be next on the hit list.
Run, Rubick.
He is alive, though.
Come on, Rubick. Oh, God. Rubick goes down, and there's a bounty rune.
It's like HFN can see it. He's just sitting
ADR
in
the only... Oh.
Okay. Okay.
AP.
Okay. Is this huge or no? No, it's not. I mean, Ben just going forward. One more hit onto the Shadow
Fiend,
but she can't find anything here. Oh, she's just eating the cogs. Oh.
He has a blink.
Ben gets killed. Rocket
Flare. Oh, he avoids the flare, too.
HFN has just been defending Megas this entire time. I feel like if she made it into
that
fight.
He might
die
fight, to be, if he's not careful.
There's a lot of damage to be done, but...
All right, well...
Radiance purchased my Centaur. Just for the stats page, basically. Just for the scoreboard.
What a game.
Yeah, we'll see if he's able to collect themselves and recompose for these next couple games. I definitely will consider them the favorite. But... And this was a really good all-around effort. You want to kind of give a tip of the hat to fucking A, but Clockwork and the Warlock, and the Centaur for that matter, played so well around him.
Great team synergy here. Yeah. I mean, you can look at the cores and say, yeah, they're the ones doing the damage, but like you mentioned, the setups are there, the initiations are there, and look at that. Just, hey, guys, I'm having some trouble mid lane. Can you scoop me out? And there we go. Another Roche going the way of fucking A.
So fucking A doesn't really have to worry about expending that buyback there, even though it was a bit greedy, so to speak, with only 20 seconds left on his respawn, but now he's got that extra life.
He's on the Shadow Fiend. They're ready to go. I mean, one more fight and the game's over. Mm-hmm. That's what it comes down to.
I mean, TA potentially could hold against Megas. The problem is they can't really turn it around. They have to kill Shadow Fiend Leshrac like four times in a row.
Bought back on this. Yeah, everybody's bought back on the rating team. They've all bought back at one point. He's actually going to be up in about a minute, so that's it.
I don't know if they have a minute at this point.
All right, well, your best, SG.
Yeah.
Come on now.
All right, TA's hanging a little loose there. He's going down the low ground. That's a full play. Oh, they still hoof stomp. All right, Rubik, let's see you get deep into the fight to use that one. Definitely a tricky game. I mean, what's the ideal fight here for the Rubik?
One, they win. Which is not, yeah, not going to happen.
I mean, yeah, technically A plus.
Not wrong. Would be ideal, but I don't know if they can.
That's absolutely either. I think he's gonna just table his solar crest for the cheese for now.
Alright.
But, I mean, this is your ticket into the Major, so you
Swap in to get the Centaur isolated. There is going to be some problems. Drop the Radiant. They fall right into Dire's trap. The upheaval keeping everyone close. They kill the Rubik Jug. Soon to follow suit. It looks like we are very close to a GG. Called out by the only survivor, the Rubik. And, oh, Midas Club, they are looking
very well played.
Very, very cohesive here.
Yeah. I would really like the idea as well to kind of take the comfort picks away, Centaur and SG. And, I mean, they had a sizable advantage in the early game, and they just weren't able to put it all together. They kind of took these micro